see that. He actually just showed a little emotion. He's like, you motherfucker. Just kidding, but I don't know what he said. But anyways, it looks like he's a little caught off guard, a little mad, to be honest. And he is taking that double gas, and Up Magic has basically double expanded after taking his first and second base, and now Light's going to go ahead and take his natural. So both players are going to be going off of three expansions and with the fourth gas here. And wow, this is going to be a long game, I have a feeling. Both players are really macroing hard right now. And you can see the ground armies. Wraith play is going to probably come out of play fairly quickly. I'm interested to see if either player is going to stick with it. And that looks like what we're taking a shot at. Doesn't look like either player really producing those right now. Putting up a couple missile turrets. That third gas can be very hard to hold for both players. Dropship play is going to come into play in a minute. And you can see their ground armies. I mean, we are four expansions and like three. Oh, there are the race. Four expansions and like three like three tanks. And it looks like Light's going to go ahead and put a little pressure on, or he could just moving out and taking positioning. But no, he has about three tanks, four Marines, and a couple of Wraiths here to put a little pressure on. And I think that's what he's going to go for. He's probably going to use that barracks here to help see his opponent, obviously. And basically, Hot Magic should know it's coming. So basically, Terran versus Terran, it can get a little dull. So just hang in there, guys. It's a pretty exciting matchup, but definitely when both players macro this hard, it can get a little dull. Up Magic's gonna be able to come in here and snipe off that supply depot, slow him down a little bit. Up Magic with definitely Light has the bigger army right now. Up Magic towing down about just two more factories. You can see that Light definitely has the more factories right now. A couple more Goliaths coming out, so he could possibly push in, try to get it contained. We do have only the one Wraith right now for Up Magic, so Light. Or we have like about the four versus four race, it looks like, coming in for a big battle, scanning very quickly for both players. The engineering bay is in position, and it looks like Light's going to be able to hold his contain a little bit, but with these race, and the last tank does go down, he's desperately trying to run away with one. Light's going to be able to come in here and put more pressure on. And things aren't looking too good for Up Magic, but he does have SCVs out to repair it, and he's going to force his opponent back just because he has those Wraiths and his opponent doesn't here. But for Light, he's going to be able to snipe off that engineering bay, and things are still very, very close in this game right now. That's nothing game deciding yet. I mean, he was able to kill the army a little bit, but he was pushed back right after reinforcements popped out. We do see the first dropship going out for his opponent here, for Light here, and then we should see a couple more dropships coming to play from Up Magic. But he still has a lot of race. He's going to be able to pick off dropships. And if he can pick off dropships, he's going to be in a great situation. You can see Up Magic is still producing those race. He's going to see what he can do. As long as he's very active with those race, and then he's going to be able to continue to put on pressure and to just rack up that gas. And then once he does enough harassment, he can go ahead and switch over. We have three dropships out here for Light. So this is where both players have taken different routes. Up Magic sticking with those race. Light has switched over to dropships. We are seeing him low up in those dropships, probably gonna go drop at the third. He does have a couple turrets over there, but that's a hard place to defend. How many Goliaths does he have? Up Magic continuing to macro, looks like taking his fifth expansion. Here coming a drop in for Light. This is definitely gonna disrupt mining with Goliaths. Those Wraiths aren't gonna be able to control this, and Light looks like he's gonna be making a move on Up Magic right now. He's gonna be able to take out a gas, which actually does hurt, but Up Magic has taken this chance to come in with cloaks and gonna be able to pick off the remainder of these tanks, it looks like, at the natural expansion. So both players taking some hits right here, and Up Magic has actually made his way up the front door of his opponent, and now Light is not moving at his natural expansion, so they're switching bases, overextending himself for Light. Light is definitely overextending himself, and Up Magic's going to take this chance, and if he can pick off this command center, that would be huge, and it looks like he will get that if he goes for it, and he's going to pick it off, and that's a big deal in Terran versus Terran. 400 minerals, and they take a while to build, and now sieging up, so both players are taking some big hits right now, and now Light is taking this chance to move up on Up Magic and disrupt another expansion right now, losing a lot of SCVs, like, get rid of those SCVs. So Up Magic needs to do some damage right now, and it looks like these Wraiths are going to come back with some cloak. You could possibly help clean this up, but there are three Goliaths over there. It's going to be a hard expansion, or a hard place to try to kill, and those dropships have picked it up. But he's losing a lot of dropships, and this could make it all. Oh, that is horrible for Light. He should have got those dropships out of there a lot quicker once he realized how much damage he was going to be able to do with his drops. He knew Wraiths were out on play. Double expanding, basically. It looks like Up Magic is taking the inner 3 o'clock expansion and now taking the bottom expansion about the 6 o'clock, and the natural is still being held for Up Magic. He's not letting Light mine from that quite yet. And is that Up Magic expanding again? Up Magic just expanding all over the map. Has dropships of his own now. But one thing to note is he still has those Wraiths, and he's been able to snipe off 3 dropships, so he's going to be able to transfer over and take the dropship lead right now. And now he's going to go back and put a little more pressure on. I don't think he's reinforcing that front door, but we do see simultaneously, we're going to see the dropships run into each other. Too bad they can't shoot each other, but Light's going to be able to see that. Oh! Up Magic losing one dropship. He's going to have to fly back with those 2 and 3. It's basically a big battle of hide and go seek. You have to constantly be hiding those dropships, running away. You can't let your opponent see where you are, and dropping right here on the high ground and being able to put some pressure on these buildings and basically be out of siege tank, be out of siege range of anything else. And here come the Wraiths. The command center has been stopped from being produced, and expansions everywhere right now. It's hard to say exactly what is going to happen. We just see Up Magic coming across the map with more force. Up Magic has a pretty good positioning on Light, so I'd have to say right now, the map control is shifting towards Up Magic. Light is being forced back. He's bringing SCVs off to transfer to the expansions. He's just going to be able to drive Up Magic's army all the way back. So Up Magic is taking a pretty good spot in this game, I have to say. I mean, it's too early to call it by far, but he is able to block these, block with SCVs, blocking all these units from going up. Light has lost a lot of his army in the middle of the map, but simultaneously, it looks like Up Magic is going to get a drop in his main base. It looks like Light's going to come in, going to take the high ground, going to be able to siege his main, and going to be able to siege his natural expansion. So simultaneously, drops going off all over the place. Up Magic in a little bit of a position problem right now, but he does have those Wraiths that are going to be able to come back and help clean this up. But with the 3 Goliaths on the high ground, it's going to be a hard place to take off, but he's almost losing all his dropships. If he loses that one dropship, he's going to have to use a scan for all of his sighting here, which isn't exactly what you want to do. And as well, Light has taken all this time to take the top 1 o'clock expansion, stop Up Magic from mining up there completely. So Up Magic is taking a good position in the middle of the map, still holding a pretty good contain on his opponent right now, but Light is just expanding on the outside rim, on the outside of the perimeters here, and I'm using this to, and then just dropping all over the place. But he is losing a lot of dropships, and this now coming in with tanks at the top expansion, at the 1 o'clock expansion, going to be able to clean that up. Going to be able to get mining up there fairly quickly. Coming in with Cloak, he's going to be able to pick up that one Goliath. If he gets his second Goliath, he's going to be in a good situation to get this back, and he is going to lose that second. Now he's going to be able to come and pick the rest of these tanks off. They're going to be able to get his natural and running again. And Light, I think he still has that drop at the 3 o'clock. Both players' APM must be out the wall right now. Must be crazy high right now. I know my words per minute, I'm stuttering all over, but my words, I'm just getting too excited. But really, it's been an exciting one so far. Up Magic definitely winning right now, I'd have to say. In a better situation, he has a contain on his opponent. He's gonna be able to take the top right. Looks like that's exactly where Light knows he must stop. He's gonna be able to drop a tank there to kill the rest of that tank, and now going to be able to go to the top right, but Up Magic knows it. Up Magic should send his reinforcements, possibly his Wraith as well, to go up there and do some more damage. One thing to note is Up Magic still has his Wraith, and his opponent does not. He's going to continue to snipe off dropships and basically snipe off those lonely tanks. Up Magic knows that he is sending a lot of SCVs there. He needs to hold that expansion, but I think he's going to be able to, with the remainder of his reinforcements on the way, he's going to be able to get on this high ground and going to be able to take out Light's forces. Light with only those 4 dropships here, and does he have, I think that's all of his drop here, so Up Magic is definitely going to hold at the top expansion. He's going to continue his position on his opponent's front door and just has them contained. But on a map like this, containing, it's a pretty slow process, I'd have to say, because there are so many perimeter expansions that your opponent can take, and that's exactly what he's doing. Up Magic, what is he doing? Losing a lot of dropships there. A little bit careless, but more importantly, he's going to be able to take out this drop. Going to be able to take out Light's chance of disrupting his mining. And he's going to have a fresh new expansion that he's going to be able to hold to all himself. And we see a lot of tanks out here for Up Magic. And still has all those tanks at the front door. Up Magic is in a good situation, playing one step ahead, being able to clean up these drops pretty quickly, not taking too much damage. Going to be able to repair those. But another dropship, another fleet of dropships heading out that way. Looks like Light is taking this time to expand twice again, one at the inner 11 and then at the 11 o'clock expansion. And we are seeing Up Magic Magic desperately trying to... Al Magic is going to see this, though. He should be fairly prepared. He's going to be able to hold that high ground. I feel he needs to use these wraiths a little more useful. I think that's what the Observer's clicking on. But they are so focused on APN that Missile Turret's going to be stopped in the middle. And here come the rest of Light's forces. And Up Magic, what kind of position is he in? Up Magic looks like he's in a fairly good position to hold this off. And what one thing Light is trying to do is to get... basically to get Up Magic to spread his units too thin that he can break out of this contain. But simultaneously, we do see Up Magic dropping a couple of tanks and a Goliath here to disrupt mining even more. So both